first and a step in stone of stones, and that impossibility of put a period to it, at least one period, is the following situation. Nazism was recognized as a hostile and unacceptable ideology which bore and bears crimes against humanity. And as for communism, it wasn't interpreted like that. And the fact that communism was never judged, it creates constant traps for analysis, description, perception that we have to recognize that European intellectuals in 2010 tried to create, and actually did create, this Prague Declaration, where they insisted that there need to be the same criteria for evaluating Nazism victims and communist regime victims. Actually, in the end, this declaration, this call from the Czech government, it didn't pass further, but I think that a step towards it was the June declaration from Europe, the European Parliament, about importance of European memory for the sake of the future, where Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact was called as the one that opened the war. But again, normalizing the Soviet past still remembers our still remains our legacy, and this normalization of the Soviet past is also a part of Ukrainian narrative and Ukrainian daily life. When sociological center does surveys, what is your attitude towards these gorgeous ribbons? If communism was condemned, then that would be like, what is your attitude on the word Nazi swastika? And then this question would be just impossible to put, because that would be prohibited by legislation. So in the end, all this concept where normalization of Soviet past is present, for Ukraine, this is a blind zone. A blind zone in history.
And actually the concept which was mentioned by my colleague here, Mr. Rafal Vnuk, about good guys from the East who were fighting against bad guys from Germany. Well, good guys from the East, they are called either Soviet guys or they called Russian guys. And in this way, actually, these Russian guys and Russia won the war, right, as it is perceived there. And the Kremlin starts this ethnization of the punishment of the crime wars and calling everybody traitors and betrayers. And this is a trap as well. Where is the place of Ukraine? Does Ukraine have its place among the victorious countries? Well, 8 million, a lot of Ukrainians in the Red Army, but what is the other place for Ukrainians here? If we're talking about the history of Eastern Europe, well, we see their role there because they were part of Ukrainian army and they came to Poland to seize its lands, and it came to Czechoslovakia. And the place of Ukraine would be also creating the front of seized nations. And actually, in Hulag, there were people who knew what they were doing, unlike Soviet people who were writing letters to Stalin. It was a terrible mistake. Ukrainians knew what for they were sent to those Hulags. So they were the perpetrators and the victims in the very same time.